touch on a handful of things and then see if there is something you want to ask about. And then we'll get out of your way so you can be sure to be out of the parking facility by 1:30. It is a very, very busy time in Cincinnati right now. There are so many things going on, and it's a challenge to keep up and to manage all of what's going on. So a few blocks from here, the bank is continuing to grow. The Christian Boyle Adams Barber House will be opening on February the 27th, which is just a few weeks off. They're currently finishing touches on that two-story restaurant. Toby Keith will be opening his place in just a couple of weeks, so we're rushing to get that done. We just announced another restaurant is coming online in April. We were just listed as the number 3 city in terms of destination points of visitors. Part of what's helping that is our hosting the World Fire Games this summer. But just the fact that more and more people in other places are taking note of Cincinnati. As you move around downtown, you'll probably notice a lot of street activity. You see a number of streets where there's construction going on, either out directly out in the street or near the sidewalk. But we are doing that on purpose. We don't normally have as much activity during the winter months, but with World Fire Games coming in July, we cannot have the streets and sidewalks torn up when that happens. So we have to get all of that done and out of the way, and that's part of our preparation. You're also moving around downtown, seeing that the casino is blasting ahead. They are scheduled to open in April of next year. And so, as of right now, it is still on schedule. In order to do that, there are a number of projects that are going to take place around the footprint of the casino out in the neighborhoods. And so, we have to make sure that those are ready so that when the casino is ready to open, we're not doing construction on the side streets and that type of thing, including make an attempt to do some straightening to Ready Road, because the way that traffic sort of snakes through there, it needs to be a whole lot smoother given the volume of traffic that's going to be coming later. In addition, if you were passed by the Aeronaut lately, you know that the 21 City Hotel construction is well underway. That will open later this year. And we intend to break ground for the streetcar probably in February. And right now we've had a wild winter, so we can talk about a lot of things right now because it hasn't been turned, but let's see how bad it gets. If you move sort of out of just talking about downtown, but other things that aren't necessarily city-driven but are bringing a lot of positive attention to the city. The fact that Barry Larkin is being enshrined in the Baseball Hall of Fame is positive for the city, because the city is now getting spotlighted around the country because he's from here. That helps us. The fact that the Bengals made the playoffs, even though we didn't do very well, still brings positive attention to the city. When you think about growth, and we believe we are in a growth mode, we finished 2011 in the black. Our income tax receipts have been going up, they are still going up. And so regardless of wherever you are on the political spectrum, that is a signal to us that the economy is continuing to improve. hiring people, more companies are calling people back to work. We can see that in the tax receipts. We still have some challenges ahead of us, but it is certainly moving in the right direction. And so that I don't get scolded later for not mentioning all the outside positive things that are helping us right now. The fact that UC was in a bowl game, went to Memphis and they actually won, drew, again, positive attention to the city. You may recall hearing the latter part of last year about some economic development changes that are happening that's positive for our tax base. So the fact that Omnicare is moving over here, the first part of 2012 was a plus. And while it has not been announced in terms of a press event, and there's not going to be a press event because this is the way the company wants it, nonetheless, Nielsen will be moving in the Chiquita building in 2 weeks. So start Nielsen, the Nielsen company that's over in Northern Kentucky, will be moving into the Chiquita building beginning on January the 20th. So that'll be 600 more people that will be mingling and working and navigating through downtown Cincinnati. On the housing front, we are continuing to see improvement. Not only are there more people living downtown, but we're seeing additional real estate activity out in some of our neighborhoods. And one of the areas where I have maintained over the last three years or so, where we need some additional growth, we still need some new market rate construction in the city limits. Can point to anecdotal examples of how that's true. The last two city rondos we did, the lots were taken in a matter of days. You may recall this summer there was a green rondo in Columbia, Tuscaloosa, where they built new houses, and those houses were priced between $560,000, $570,000. They all sold really fast. And really what that tells a person like me, the city manager's role, is there is a demand for new. Not everyone wants a 100-year-old house. And we have a number of neighborhoods that have older properties, and particularly some of the younger professionals want newer construction, and even some of the other folks, when we look at who is living at the banks, because all the apartments are gone, we assume that it would be a lot of young professionals that would want to live at the banks. Well, yes, they are living there, but we have seen a number of cases where people whose children have moved on, and they don't want as much house, decided they want to live back in the city, so they have